Okay, so the next part of our agenda, we're going to bring up Emily, and she is going to go over a little bit about, especially those of you that this is going to be your first time around, what should you be planning to bring with you? You know, what is the packing of camp look like over the next week as we get ready to go? So it's all yours.
And just a reminder about your folders, please make sure you do not lose them, do not throw away the papers, and that you bring them on June 3rd. You also need to bring me a birthday gift because it's my birthday. Okay? In your folders, though, it's going to give you a list. This list I never saw at my first year of Camp Fitch last year. Therefore, I pretty much wore the same clothes every day. I wore the same leggings for at least 5 days. So it's just an overview. Obviously you're showering out there. You're going to want shampoos, conditioners, hairbrush, extra hair ties, towels. Your towels are going to start to smell, bring extra. Something that I also learned from the girls is a lot of people buy like the 3-door plastic containers instead of bringing like a suitcase, because obviously we sleep outside. There's animals, there's bugs, there's spiders. Okay, so they bring the 3 drawers and they pack all their clothes inside of that. And then they have a whole separate one for like their flashlights, bug spray, toiletries, like their shampoos and things like that as well. So those are all important things. Another thing that I didn't bring cash. Bring some cash because there's activities that you can pay to do just as well as your campers. So your campers will pay for X amount of things. I didn't have cash. What else did I forget? Like a small book bag.
That cash does not stay with you.
Yeah.
That cash will go in the bank. Do not plan on keeping cash like chilling in your person. It won't hang out with you. It'll either be like in your car or in the bank.
Right.
You don't want to.
So like you have a Fitch bank account and then your money is, you can use your money that way. Right? Some other things, I forgot what I was about to say.
Sorry.
That's okay.
I just didn't want to hold my pants. I'm trying to chill it out with my kids and steal from me.
Backpack, yes. So bring some sort of small backpack, satchel, fanny pack, whatever it is that you want that you can have, like a first aid kit that we're going to provide for you guys, bug spray, sunscreen, maybe a sweatshirt, a rain jacket. It rains out of nowhere some days, okay? Things like that you can have extra, or if you're hiking and you want water shoes and your tennis shoes to change out of. Another thing is make sure you have proper shoes. We can't just wear flip-flops or our nice sandals. We need closed-toed shoes, Crocs, things like that are closed that you can hike, that you can run, that you can do all those sorts of things. It's a rocky surface, there's grass, all of those things. What else am I forgetting? Oh, on the first day, we ask that you bring a pair of khaki-like shorts. Khaki, black, blue, navy, whatever it is that you can find, because we will be providing staff shirts for you. And we like to wear those on like the first and last day. That way, parents and anyone that's bringing up their children, they can point us out, they can see us, and that way we look professional. So try to bring a pack, at least one pair of khakis. Guys, I know obviously that's a little easier for you. So girls, grab some of your shorts, okay? You want your crap clothes for poor term. Things that you don't care if get ruined or dirty. If you go on a hike and get lost in the woods for an hour or so and you don't care if it gets ruined. Let's see. Extra things to have on hand, like frisbees, ball. A lot of the girls bring the whatever they're called, the light. What do you guys use those lights that light up here?
The bubble thing?
The bubble lights.
Oh, the paper lantern thing?
Yeah, paper lanterns so they can light up their events. You guys can decorate your events. I know guys don't necessarily do that. Make sure you bring a sleeping bag, pillow, and maybe an extra blanket. It gets cold, we're right on the lake, okay? What else? Medications get director, a counselor, or a child. And then I just called her the Fitch nurse. I don't know, is it the same lady this year?
What?
The Fitch nurse?
No, no. Well, not me.
Okay, so someone new. Your inhalers, EpiPens, if you have allergies, all those things, make sure that you let us know as staff as well. Things to leave at home. Most of you know, obviously, we don't chew tobacco, cigarettes, things like that. Don't bring vape pens. I work in the high school, please do not vape at Camp Fitch. Okay. Also, no electronics. Your phones, will explain more once we're down there, I guess. Essentially, we take your phones and you have your phones on certain hours. As well as try to stay away from bringing headphones unless it's in the evening, your MP3 players. Try to keep that stuff out of sight from the kids because the kids can't have it as well. So if they see you on your phone, which most of them won't, then they're going to want to do the same thing. Because in our day and age, everyone has some sort of phone, electronic, tablet, and you'll see them try to bring those items as well. So try to set the example that this, we're in a nature zone, we're learning, and we're camping, we're doing outdoors things and staying away from electronics. I'll let you cover the prank area. I don't know that answer. Yeah, because I wasn't around when the pranks happened. You can bring cameras, backpacks, I said hats, bathing suits. Guys and girls. Girls, obviously we require a one-piece. Do you require a one piece or at least like a tankini, right? Okay. Tankinis. Guys, let's refrain from the Speedos and let's get some swim trunks, okay? I don't think we have those.
Let's get some swim trunks that like come down, okay? But let's not get some swim trunks that are like right here.
Okay? I don't want to see it.
I'm not seeing it again.
I don't want to see it.
I want it to touch the knee.
Make sure that our straps or they are not cut off so that we're showing off refrain from spaghetti straps that's just a little bit revealing, especially with some of the younger guys and girls that we have. So try to stick with like this more athletic, sporty Razorbacks. And not too tight of clothing. Let's not show off the world. We don't need to show off. And what's the other one?
It's just a really good rule of thumb to just, if you're questioning something, yeah, to just probably leave it at home.
Yeah.
Because we're all really comfortable. I wear a lot of crummy stuff, so like I'm real comfortable coming up and being like, I'm uncomfortable with what you're wearing. Also, I am related and real comfortable with a lot of the boy directors, so they're comfortable saying, I don't like what they're wearing and it makes me uncomfortable, so I can then be like, you need to change. Because if it's making the guy directors uncomfortable, then it's probably distracting the guy counselors, so you need to change. And that's kind of how it goes with a lot of the Zulu girls too, so they need to change as well. So just kind of, if you're thinking that you wear this to impress somebody, you should probably leave it at home. And I speak more so for the girls because most of the time you guys, I've never really had an issue. So
I would like to say something. I think of you guys as adults, right? So I think of you as walking into a role that an adult would have. And so what I say for my camp staff at Westland is I print them out an article and I explain to them that they are adults. But as an adult, you need to dress appropriately for your job. So is it safe to wear? Is it appropriate to wear? Would it be appropriate if you had a child in the program, would you want to see their counselor every day? Those are the type of things that you should be focusing on. I personally, I'm not looking at whether or not you're distracting guys because of kind of guys' problem, sorry. I am looking at whether or not you are appropriate to work with children. So look at it through that lens a little bit more so, because if you are going to really climb a rock wall in spaghetti straps and booty shorts, it's gonna hurt, right? Like it's gonna hurt. If you're comfortable, you're gonna have issues involved in that. It's not gonna work.
So it's gonna distract some people.
So it's not going to work. So you need to dress appropriate for the people.
The other one is crop tops. Stay away from crop tops, as well as make sure that you don't have any profanity on your clothing. Don't have beer bottles on your shirts, beer on your hat, your Bud Light hat. Try not to bring that stuff. Because we are still representing the Y. If you have Y shirts, wear them. Right? If you need Y shirts, ask me. Have them lots. Alright?